A very good morning, my dear students. I welcome you all for VTU eShikshana program. Myself, Dr. Madhukeshwara N, Professor of Mechanical Engineering Department, Jain Institute of Technology, Davanagere. My email ID madhu_keshwara@yahoo.co.in. My mobile numbers are 9242202964 and one more 77958-79628. Today I am going to deliver a lecture on thermal radiation, that is module 4 of heat transfer subject of mechanical engineering department, 6th semester BE. It is as per choice based credit system, CBSE scheme. You can note down my email ID and phone numbers. For any clarifications or doubts, you can contact me on these numbers or mail ID on this chapter of thermal radiation. This chapter, thermal radiation, involves fundamental principles of gray, white, opaque, transparent and black bodies, spectral emissive power, Wien's law, Rayleigh-Jeans law and Planck's law. It also involves hemispherical emissive power, Stefan-Boltzmann law for the total emissive power of a black body, emissivity and Kirchhoff laws. It consists of view factor, net radiation exchange in a two-body enclosure, typical examples for these enclosures, radiation shield. So what is thermal radiation? Let me define first what is thermal radiation. Thermal radiation is a distinct mechanism from conduction and convection for transfer of heat energy. It refers to the heat energy by the bodies because of their temperatures. All solids and liquid surfaces at all temperatures above absolute zero temperature emits thermal radiation. Radiation is the heat transfer by emission of internal energy. The intensity of such radiation depends upon temperature and nature of the surface. Thermal radiation is heat emitted as a result of energy transition of molecules, atoms and electrons of the substance. Temperature is the measure of thermal radiation and rate of thermal radiation increases with increasing temperature. Unlike conduction and convection, radiation does not require any presence of the medium. So, the overall theme is that thermal radiation is a property which depends upon the temperature and it does not require any medium to transfer from one place to another place. Again, radiation is a volumetric phenomena. However, frequently it is more convenient to treat it as a surface phenomena. It may be defined as the transfer of heat loss across a system boundary by means of electromagnetic waves. That is, by the mechanism of photon emission or electromagnetic wave emission, which is caused by temperature difference. Electromagnetic waves or electromagnetic radiation represents the energy emitted by matter as a result of the changes in the electromagnetic configuration of the atoms or molecules. The radiation is the only mechanism for heat transfer whenever vacuum is present. Because of the mechanism of transmission is photon emission, unlike conduction and convection, there need be no intermediate matter to enable transmission. Means it is the only mechanism where it can travel through vacuum. So no medium is required. Basic theory of radiation heat transfer. Two theories which explain heat transfer by radiation are Maxwell's wave theory and Max Planck's quantum theory. So, what is Maxwell's wave theory? According to Maxwell's electromagnetic wave theory, the energy is transmitted from a hot body to a cold body in the form of electromagnetic waves. The electromagnetic waves process the energy emitted by the body as a result of the change in electromagnetic configuration of atoms or molecules. Two characteristics of electromagnetic waves are wavelength lambda and frequency nu. Lambda is equal to c by nu, where c is the speed of propagation of wave in that medium. Engineering applications concerning electromagnetic radiation covers a wide range of wavelengths. All electromagnetic waves travel at the speed of light in vacuum. The second theory is Max Planck's quantum theory. According to Max Planck's concept, the propagation of thermal radiation takes place in the form of discrete quanta called photons. The size of quanta is different. The energy of the quantum is given by E is equal to h into nu, or h into c divided by lambda, where h is Planck's constant, which is equal to 6.6260.7004 into 10 to the power of minus 34 kg meter square per second, and c is velocity of light in the medium, which is equal to 2.9979 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. Quantum will have more energy if the frequency of the quantum is higher. It is evident from this equation that E is directly proportional to the nu, that is the frequency. Means for higher frequency, energy will be more. Therefore, quantum will have more energy if frequency of the quantum is higher. The true nature of the radiation and its transport mechanism is not completely known to the scientists. Neither of the two theories explained here can give the satisfactory answer to the radiation heat transfer process. However, both of them are useful in explaining uncertain and unknown phenomena of radiation. Some of the examples of radiation are heat leakage from furnaces, heat leakage from combustion chambers, solar energy incident upon Earth, heat liberation during nuclear explosions, heat dissipation from the bulb filament, heat leakage through the evacuated walls of thermos flask, heat from the stove burner, heat emitted from household electric heater, heat emitted from Earth, which is having much lower intensity. Finally, heat emitted from bonfire. Electromagnetic waves. Electromagnetic waves are transverse waves. They consist of alternating electric and magnetic force fields at 90 degrees to one another and in the direction of energy transfer. A representation of part of an electromagnetic wave is shown in the figure. You can see that electrical field and magnetic field are at 90 degrees to one another and it is in the direction of energy transfer. These forces are generated by changes in the speed or direction of moving electric charge. Some properties of electromagnetic waves are as follows. Electromagnetic wave propagation does not require any medium to travel. All electromagnetic waves can pass through a vacuum. Electromagnetic waves travel the vacuum of space at the common speed of light 300 million meters per second, that is 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. Almost all the energy that reaches the earth from the sun is in the form of electromagnetic radiation. It takes 8 minutes for light from the sun to reach the earth. The inherent characteristics of an electromagnetic wave is its frequency. Their frequencies remains unchanged, but its wavelength changes when the wave travels from one medium to another medium. The energy is carried by electric and magnetic fields of electromagnetic waves are equal. That is, electric energy and magnetic energy are equal in electromagnetic waves. It is here very important to know electromagnetic wave spectrum. What is electromagnetic wave spectrum? It is nothing but it is a continuum of electromagnetic waves with artificial divisions based on the frequency and wavelengths of the waves. Figure here shows artificial divisions based on the frequency and wavelengths of electromagnetic waves. That is called as the electromagnetic spectrum. This electromagnetic spectrum covers wavelengths from 10 to the power of minus 10 micrometer for cosmic rays to 10 to the power of 10 micrometer for electrical power waves, including gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet radiation, visible light, infrared radiation, thermal radiation, microwaves, and radio waves. Electromagnetic spectrum is the range of all possible frequencies of electromagnetic radiation. Electromagnetic radiation extends over a wide range of energies that are wavelengths of frequencies. The electromagnetic waves are grouped into types that have similar wavelengths and so have similar properties. Electromagnetic waves form a continuous series in order of changing wavelength frequency and energy. This series is called electromagnetic spectrum. Electromagnetic radiation in the range of 0.4 micrometer to 0.7 micrometer is known as visible region, and white light contains a mix of all wavelengths in this visible region. It is evident from the previous figure. It is very important at this point to discuss radiation properties of surfaces. Radiation is a property of all substances, and each emits energy, and amount of energy emitted depends on the temperature. Radiation energy falling on a body is partly reflected, partly transmitted, and partly absorbed. If the total incident energy is QI, is falling on the object as shown in the figure below. Now you can see QI falling on the object. Then QA is energy absorbed. See, QA is the energy absorbed in the body. QR is energy reflected. QR is reflected energy. And QT is energy transmitted. And QT is the energy transmitted. Theoretically, incident radiation is nothing but sum of absorbed, transmitted and reflected radiation. This figure shows the reflection, incident and absorption of radiation. Incident energy is equal to sum of absorbed, reflected and transmitted energies, as it is evident from the previous figure. Therefore, Qi is equal to Qa plus Qr plus Qt. Dividing this entire equation by Qi, left hand side Qi by Qi cancels and it will be 1. Right hand side it will be Qa by Qi, Qr by Qi and Qt by Qi, summation of all the three terms. Therefore, 1 is equal to alpha plus rho plus tau, that is the summation of alpha absorptivity, rho reflectivity and tau transmittivity. For particular wavelength, the amount of reflected energy depends upon the type of material, the surface finish and the angle of incidence. Now we will discuss what are the different types of bodies or concept of different bodies and their properties. The first one and the very important one is a black body. Black body is nothing but it is an object that absorbs all the radiant energy reaching its surface from all the direction with all the wavelengths. For a black body, transmission, that is tau, is equal to 0, absorption, that is alpha, is equal to 1 and reflection, that is rho, is equal to 0. In reality, a perfect black body does not exist, but this concept of a black body is very important in radiation heat transfer. Black body means it is the thing which absorbs all the energy. So any body which appears black is not a black body. The body, ideal body, which absorbs all the radiation is called a black body. It is assumed that the black body has maximum emissive power at a particular temperature compared with other bodies. So these are all only assumptions. There is no perfect black body in the universe. The concept of a black body is an idealization. A black body may be approximated as follows. A cavity is constructed as shown in the figure 4 that I will show in the next slide, so that it is large compared with the size of the opening provided. An incident ray through the opening is reflected many times on the inside before finally escaping from the opening. Now you can see that we have a large body, that is circular cavity. It is provided with a small opening. Through this opening, light enters into this circular cavity and reflects many times on the inside surfaces and finally escapes through the opening. With each reflection, it is clear that there is a fraction of energy absorbed corresponding to the absorptivity of the surface of the cavity. After many absorptions, practically all of the incident radiation is absorbed. So this is nothing but we can say that once the light source enters into the body and reflects many times inside in this circular cavity, and each time little bit of radiation is absorbed, and if the reflections are more number of times, then much of the radiation is absorbed inside the body itself, and finally there will be no light remaining to get out of the circular cavity through the body. This means the entire radiation is absorbed by the cavity. This is an idealization of black body. So what is black body radiation? A body at a thermodynamic temperature above zero emits radiation in all direction over a wide range of wavelengths is called as black body radiation. The amount of radiation emitted from the surface at a given wavelength depends on the material of the body and the condition of its surface. Also, it depends on the surface temperature. At a specified temperature and wavelength, no surface can emit more energy than a black body. A black body absorbs all incident radiation regardless of wavelength and direction. This means it is a perfect absorbing body. No surface has precisely the properties of a black body. As I told you, it is an ideal body. Therefore, no surfaces are having properties which are equivalent to the black body. Black body is in general is a perfect emitter with an emissivity of 1. Also absorbs all the incident energy. And it is a non-reflective opaque body and a diffuse emitter. An ideal black body in thermal equilibrium has two notable properties that are, it is an ideal emitter. So what do you mean by ideal emitter? Ideal emitter is nothing but at every frequency the body emits as much as or more thermal radiative energy as any other body with highest emissive power at the same temperature. The next property is it is a diffuse emitter. It emits radiation energy isotropically and uniformly in all the directions per unit area normal to the direction of emission. So these are the properties of black body. That is, it is an ideal emitter and it is a diffuse emitter. An approximate realization of a black surface is a hole in the wall of a large insulated enclosure. That is nothing but you can take the example of an oven. Any light entering the hole is reflected or absorbed at the internal surfaces of the body and is unlikely to re-emerge, making the hole a nearly perfect absorber. It is similar to that of earlier circular cavity where radiation is completely absorbed. The second type of the body is called as white body. This has a rough surface that reflects all incident rays completely and uniformly in all directions. For example, a white body is having transmission tau 0, absorption alpha 0 and reflection rho is equal to 1. Means it reflects entire radiation which falls on the surface. Next one, gray body. It is a body whose absorptivity of the surface does not vary with the variation in the temperature and wavelength of the incident radiation. A gray body is one where absorption alpha, reflection rho and transmission tau are uniform for all wavelengths. So, in this body, absorptivity of the surface does not vary with the temperature and wavelength. So, for all wavelengths, absorption, reflection and transmission are uniform. That type of body is called as gray body. Next one, the opaque body. It is the body in which it transmits none of the radiation that reaches its surface, although some may be reflected. That is, transmission is equal to zero for this body, and absorption alpha and reflection rho is equal to 1. That is, the sum of absorption alpha and reflection rho is equal to 1. Transparent body. When all the irradiation is transmitted through the body, it is called as transparent body. For a white body, if transmission tau is equal to 1, absorption alpha is equal to 0 and reflection rho is equal to 0, then this type of body is called as transparent body. Means practically doesn't absorb any radiation and doesn't reflect also any radiation. The entire radiation falling on the body is transferred or it is transmitted through the body. The very important terms are spectral or monochromatic emissive power and total emissive power. At a given temperature, the total amount of heat energy emitted by the surface in all the direction over entire wavelength per unit area per unit time is called total emissive power. This total emissive power depends on characteristics and temperature of the surface. It is designated as E and measured in watt per meter square. Total emissive power E is a function of emissivity epsilon, wavelength lambda and temperature T, where epsilon is emissivity of the surface, lambda is the wavelength of radiation in micrometer, T is absolute temperature of the surface in Kelvin. Monochromatic emissive power is the another term which we need to define here. It is nothing but is the energy transmitted by the surface at an absolute temperature T per unit time, per unit surface area and per unit wavelength d lambda about the wavelength lambda in all the directions. It is denoted as E lambda and measured in watt per meter square micrometer. The radiation is emitted over the wavelength ranges from lambda is equal to 0 to lambda is equal to infinity. The emissive power of the surface over the wavelength ranges from lambda to lambda plus d lambda and is given by E lambda is equal to dE by d lambda or dE is equal to E lambda into d lambda, where dE is emissive power in watt per meter square and E lambda is monochromatic emissive power in watt per meter square micrometer. Now you can see that the emissive power versus wavelength. The y-axis indicates the emissive power and x-axis indicates the wavelength, where d lambda is nothing but it is the particular range of wavelength. The total energy emitted by the surface at a given temperature is the addition of radiant energy at all wavelengths, and it is known as total emissive power of the surface at a given temperature. The total emissive power of a black body can be calculated by adding all the radiant energy at all the wavelengths from 0 to infinity at a particular temperature. That is, the total emissive power of the surface over entire spectrum of wavelengths is given by the following expression. Means E is equal to integration between the limits 0 to infinity E lambda into d lambda, where E lambda is a function of lambda at a particular temperature. As we already know that lambda is nothing but it is wavelength. Now, at a particular temperature, wavelength of a black body radiates much more energy at higher temperature than at a lower temperature. And at any temperature, the amount of energy emitted varies with the wavelength. It can also be seen from figure 6 that the energy of thermal radiation is almost negligible for extremely long wavelengths. Now figure 6 shows monochromatic emissive power versus wavelength. Now you can see this is the x-axis which indicates the wavelength and y-axis indicates the emissive power. Now thermal radiation energy is almost negligible for extremely long wavelengths. Means as the wavelength here, you can see as it increases, then the monochromatic emissive power decreases. Therefore, for longer wavelengths, emissive power is lesser. It is very important to learn Stefan Boltzmann equation in this chapter of radiation. The relationship known as the Stefan Boltzmann equation for a black body emissive power is given by E suffix B is equal to sigma into T to the power of 4, where sigma is a constant which is equal to 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power of 4. This is known as Stefan Boltzmann constant and EB is the total emissive power. The total emissive power or the emissive power is defined as the total thermal radiation emitted from a surface per unit time and per unit area. Similarly, Stefan Boltzmann law states that the amount of radiation energy emitted per unit time, per unit area of a black body is proportional to the fourth power of its absolute temperature. From Planck's law, monochromatic emissive power of a black body is given by this following equation, where E suffix B lambda at a temperature T is equal to C1 divided by lambda to the power of 5 into exponential C2 divided by lambda T minus 1. Hence, the radiation energy emitted by a black body at an absolute temperature T over all wavelength per unit time per unit area can be determined by integrating the above equation. From lambda is equal to 0, to lambda is equal to infinity. Therefore, E suffix B is equal to integration between the limits of wavelengths 0 to infinity E B lambda into D lambda, where this value of E B lambda is substituted from this equation and we will get the next equation as E suffix B is equal to integration between the limits 0 to infinity. That is, this equation is nothing but substitution of this value of E B lambda. So that is C1 divided by lambda to the power of 5 into exponential C2 divided by lambda T minus 1 into D lambda. let C2 by lambda t is equal to x and C2 by xt is equal to lambda, rearranging the previous equation. Or again, d lambda is equal to minus C2 divided by x square t into dx, differentiating this equation. And the unit here changes as at lambda is equal to 0, x is equal to infinity. And at lambda is equal to infinity, x changes to 0. Hence, the above equation becomes E suffix B is equal to minus C1 integration between limits 0 to infinity x to the power of 5 t to the power of 5 C2 divided by C2 to the power of 5 into ex minus e to the power of x minus 1 into x square t into dx. Upon simplification, we will get eb is equal to c1 t to the power of 4 divided by c2 to the power of 4, which is taken outside the integration, and integration of 0 to infinity x cube ex minus 1 to the power of minus 1 into dx. Again, expansion of this term in the next equation will become as e suffix b is equal to c1 t to the power of 4 divided by c2 to the power of 4, integration between the limits 0 to infinity, expansion of this term will be x to the power of 3 minus 1 into e to the power of minus x plus e to the power of minus 2x plus e to the power of minus 3x and dx. The above integral is the form of integration between limits 0 to infinity x to the power of n into e to the power of minus ax into dx, which is equal to n factorial divided by a to the power of n plus 1. Hence, the above equation becomes e suffix b is equal to c1 t to the power of 4 c2 to the power of 4 into 3 factorial divided by 1 plus 3 factorial divided by 2 to the power of 4 plus 3 factorial divided by 3 to the power of 4 plus so on. Therefore, EB is equal to C1 T to the power of 4 divided by C2 2 to the power of 4 into 6.48. Substituting the values of C1 and C2 in the above equations, we will get EB is equal to 3.7415 into 10 to the power of minus 16 t to the power of 4 divided by 1.4388 into 10 to the power of minus 2 whole to the power of 4 into 6.48. EB is equal to 5.657 into t to the power of 4 into 100 to the power of minus 4. Again, after simplification, we will get EB is equal to 5.657 into 10 to the power of minus 8 t to the power of 4. That is, EB is equal to sigma into t to the power of 4 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power of 4, where sigma is known as a Stefan-Boltzmann constant, whose value is 5.657 into 10 to the power of minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power of 4. Hence, Stefan-Boltzmann law states that the rate of radiation heat transfer per unit area from a black body surface is directly proportional to 4th power of absolute temperature of the black body surface. Means, radiation heat transfer per unit area from a black surface is proportional to the 4th power of absolute temperature of black body surface. With this, I wind up today's session. I'll continue with some more concepts in the next session. Thank you very much.